Hello and welcome back to 30 Minute Valheim with Cody. I am Cody. And I was quitting in the middle last night of having a... Last night, whenever I was playing. Small island that I wanted to build here. Gonna need to want to get back to sort of a safe area. I'm exploring the swamps down here. And essentially looking for just more good places to be swampy. Good place to land close to Bonemass, which for me would be something like, I don't know, just somewhere that there wouldn't be a lot of enemies while I'm trying to rest up and go back and forth. And this is just meant here to be a temporary stay over. Essentially just to go get my bearings, protect and repair my boat. Sure I've got enough daytime to boat around where I want to go. At this point, I'm not even sure what time of day it is. I'm looking at the sun just now. And I also don't really know which portal I'm on right now. It's not set up. But I'm going to guess BF9 or BF7, one or the other. Let's see. Okay, so that does connect to BF9. What happens when you run through it. Are we back in the maze? Am I not? Right? That's not the one then. I guess I'll take a look at a map and kind of think about what I'm doing. I got a 6, I got a 9. Wait a few seconds there to be careful to make sure I don't get stuck. It's happened to me already before. Right, shouldn't have much in there except for the wood. I can always go check on my farm while I'm here. I don't think I've got any real other set of things going. It's pretty stable. Oh, where is the farm? Implement. Let's go upstairs. Notice I got a few repairs to do. Might as well do those. Do I have everything I need on me at this stage? Extra stamina potion. Can I store that? Only if I store this where it's supposed to be. It goes downstairs. Why, that's there. go ahead and do the farming. I think she'll be ready now. I think that's a valid passage of time overnight. They look pretty close. Yep, looks done. Those are the ones I was waiting on. So, all right, go ahead and garden. Keep the turnip train going. Yeah, always choices. I did want to go ahead and get these turnips continued. You know, see what sort of food I can make or store them. And I've got 44 seeds I can plant. Or I can continue my boating expedition. I just like to do a bit of the keep the food cycle going. So I have plenty of time to boat. I'm going to keep my eye on that a little bit. We started with 18 rest, but set, so I've been a minute into this. Yeah, go ahead and plant. Hello. Straight up turnip seed. Turnips. Five rows of eight. Doesn't sound so hard. And that's the turnips. That was just a couple of minutes. Another big whoop. 3 hours into the day. I've got turnip foods here. I'm going to drop the rest of the turnips off. Get this in my seed bucket. Health on hand. Yeah, milkshake. More milkshake. Can you need more milkshake? Yes, I can. A couple milkshakes. What's up out here? Yep. Easy to get smoked out. Well, I'm making sausage. What am I missing? Oh, I didn't grab the entrails.
Not bad.
To the sailing area, BF7. Lovely headwind. This way, which is right now exactly where the wind is blowing. It's kind of not what I want to be doing is fighting wind right now. Plenty of other things to be doing. Fighting wind doesn't have to be one of them. Yeah, so looking for swamps for places to take down an abomination so I can get more root armor and continue that upgrade path. Certainly with the main priority. Having wood is always a priority, though. So, while that weather is continuing to look like it is directly in the direction that I want to be traveling, I'm going to go do a little wood chopping. Keep an eye on the wind while I'm doing so. Stop and get a piece of carrot food. So I'm on that stamina diet. There we go. Oh, okay, the wind has changed a bit, but it's still pretty much mostly the direction I want to go, so getting into that yet. Need a complete reversal of that wind direction. I'm running around the little base perimeter looking for wood. Deer right now. Plenty of deer stuffs. Hut here, if I remember right, had some things near it. But I don't know, there's been a few huts I've been around. Don't see anything near this one. So this is fair game. Chop it. Yes. Feel the elder power. The wind is not in my favor, but it's only really cold right now. That's the benefit of the electric. I know when I ride without power, I really notice that wind, you know? It's right in your face. It doesn't want to... It's challenging you. If I'm going to be challenged by nature, it's usually here and out. Why I live in Los Angeles, I don't be challenged by the nature. Winter has just been too much. Rain just is good, but not when you're trying to get on an electric bicycle. Yeah. The other part of the rain is good. Really trying to complain. Just love my electric bike. Love the typical weather we have. Looking forward to it coming back. Don't like the years-long drought. of a happy medium somewhere. That's not always the way life works out. Sometimes you just get crap. So look at that. The wind is sort of changing, but at this point, it's about midday, and I don't want to just get in the boat and fly for 5 hours and then have to find a place to go. So hopefully what we'll get is a little bit of a lucky wind. That one, this direction, that direction is going now would be great, but I'm just going to see what it's like in the morning. Go ahead and cut some trees. A minute with the elder left here. Getting a little off track. Let's get back over. I like it when it one-shots. Alright, just kind of keep in mind I went a little further west and slightly south. Knocked down a bunch of trees, so next time I want to go find some lumber. So that should be the first place I run to. Cut some of the time out. Spreading out here with my tree eradication. Slip over that piece of wood for no reason. Off the wood that I got. Other knickknacks. Oh, look at that. Really building up the wood now. Use more fine wood, but I will certainly be needing more all kinds of wood as the game progresses. Oh, burn through that axe, too. Back out there. And run wherever. Still plenty of sun left to grab the trees that I've put on the ground. Start with the fine wood. Left over here on the ground and go back and chop that other fine wood tree and then kind of work away from there just because. It's a little bit more of a priority after that. Seeing how much you got in the buckets there. Bang, you hit the ground. Bang, bang, what an office. My baby done gone fall down. Someone today was talking about seeing Taiki Waititi. With the way they said it, I thought they said Taikasi. I didn't know who Taikasi was, but I nodded along. And later in their story, they clarified or just repeated Taiki Waititi. And then I knew who they meant. Anyway, someone said probably best not to have said hello. Maybe he would have been mean. I don't know why. Maybe because he's. That like particularly they would have said that. Just having been on the heels of a lot of award-winning moments, maybe we wonder why this person was randomly talking to him. I don't know. It's the sort of thing people wonder about sometimes out here. I've talked to a couple of interesting people I know from things on television, a little bit of film over the years, but usually in a setting where it's like everyone kind of knows everyone, and it's just a person who happens to be a little more famous than some of the people in the room, sometimes a lot more, but maybe a different time, or they have some other common interest. And but one time, just in a bar, saw someone I knew from shows, Eric Wareheim, and just went to say hello briefly, kind of in a moment when it just seemed like he was waiting on someone who wasn't there yet, and just kind of staring aimlessly at his phone, so it felt like a good time just to say hello, and it worked out fine. He was very friendly, smiled, thanked me for expressing my fandom of his work, and quickly said, I can tell you're waiting on someone, so I'm going to give you your space, and backed off, and you know, didn't seem bothered at all. All went about her business. Just a normal person. People are gonna recognize. So it seemed like at least he's just kind of like being recognized. Just after, I think Tim and Eric had already been on the air for a few years. It might have even already been off. At that point, I was really just more into what Eric Wareheim does with music videos, which does quite a bit of really amazing music videos throughout the years. In some ways, introducing me, or at least reinforcing my knowledge of other very good artists, musicians. So I thank him for that, and I wanted to thank him in person for that. And I got that chance, and it was everything I always thought it would be. But I doubt he'd remember me that day. Probably one of many for him. Day 103 here in 30 Minute Valheim. Just killing time, getting wood, wanting the wind to be on my side, and right now it couldn't be better. That is exactly the direction I want to go from my location. So let me get over there and move. So BF7 is my portal home. Let's see if I remember it this time. I do want to go northwest. I want to mostly go west. Let's get out of here as fast as possible. Alright, come in with me, Wood. Get in, Wood. We're going shopping. Hey, little deer. We are going shopping for geography. Trying to get the lay of the land. A little bit further away from this little bank. Before the wind decides it's coming up and change on me, let's get going. It's shifted a little bit more north, that's okay. I got a nice crosswind when I'm cutting west, I'm happy. Tailwind would hurt. Can't quite tell what's going up in the landscape here. There's a lot of islands. So I'm assuming there's going to be swampland, but it might just be weird meadow islands. Or it might be some strange combination of tiny plains, islands, meadows. What exactly is going on? I'm going to get on the safe side and get a little further away. Just one little visit from a death skeeto and I'm in a world of hurt. And you know, I'm not too far away by carve, etc. I'm the closest. All these islands set up with these lore on them. It's a real patchy area. You see a mountain far up there in the distance. I'm not sure what I got going on with the land here. meadows, I feel okay. There's some bone mass in there. There's some plains scattered throughout. And some swamps. A big, massive swamp area. I have no idea if that part right there is plains or meadows. It can be deceiving sometimes. Can't quite see if those are beech trees or not, or just all birch. Swamp in the background. It's possible that that plains bit was just kind of an anomaly. We have a lot of swamp. This could be then the place I want to land for the swamp land that's going to Bonemass. That plains just sort of scared me off. I am going to take a guess that that way is continuous swamp to bone mass. I don't see any reason to think not. Swamps are deceptive from afar. So hopefully this just isn't, this is actually meadows and no plains. I'm going to get a sneak up in there, take a look. Now I'm going against the grain, but that's the adventure part about adventuring. You never know quite exactly what's going to happen. I don't know if I'm going to find crypts in here and get a little bit more iron. I'm not sure if I'm going to find an abomination. Or if a death skeeto is going to come running through the area and just completely decimate me. Okay about just leaving my boat here, building a little meadows tent shack, getting on with the world. But I do have my eye on that small patch of plains I certainly saw with that large stone column. Not ready for that stuff. I don't want to try to face a wolf right now in the mountains, much less a fueling or anything else out there. So this looks like a good enough place. Before I go, let's go ahead and level it as high as I can get it. Basics of what I did before, 2x2, 4 meter by 4 meter. Thing up. EF7, and that's it. I'm going to pop back home, and that's it for this 30-minute episode of 30 Minute Valheim with Cody. I'm Cody. Bye.